song came to us with the guy who had written it. You know, I had this undercurrent guitar thing, but it was very subdued and very soft. And only after we rehearsed it and kind of put some, you know, oomph into it, did it slowly evolve into what the record was.
Like many of the classic songs we've looked at in Making of a Hit, the success of Born to be Wild came only after a struggle.
I particularly like it when people come up to me now and say, well, you know, it's a classic. Everybody knew that I had hit written all over. Turns out that we had quite a pretty well with the record company because they were convinced it should be the B-side of the single. And so finally a compromise was reached whereby we would put Born to be Wild and this other song back to back, release the record, and let radio decide which of the songs they liked.
Born to be Wild went all the way to number 2 on the U.S. charts, but over the years, the song has grown in stature and come to epitomize the urge to let loose. It has been used in nearly a dozen films for just that reason, either dramatically as an easy rider or comedically as in Lost in America.
It was really with Tom that the tune sort of gathered momentum and became this anthem that somehow managed to tap into the essence of adolescence and rebellion, because every set of 50-year-olds is convinced that they too are going to be rebellious.